ago, I had a favorite story of the Meadowlark who lived where the rivers wind. Her voice could match the angels in its glory, but she was blind. The lark was blind. An old king came and took her to his palace, where the walls were burnished bronze and golden grey. And he fed her fruit and nuts from an ivory chalice, and he prayed, "Sing for me, my meadowlark, sing for me on this silver morning, set me free, my meadowlark, and I'll buy your priceless jewel and cloth of brocade and crewel. For life, if you will sing for me." Then one day, as the lark sang by the water, the god of the sun heard her in his flight, and her singing moved him, so he came and brought her the gift of sight. He gave her sight, and she opened her eyes to the shimmer and the splendor of this beautiful young god, so proud and strong. And he called to the lark in a voice both rough and tender, "Come along, fly with me, my meadowlark, fly with me on the silver morning, past the sea. Peaches, just as far as your vision reaches, fly with me." But the meadowlark said no, for the old king loved her so, she couldn't bear to wound his pride. So the sun god flew away, and when the king came down that day, he found his meadowlark had died. Every time I heard that part, I cry. And now I stand here, starry-eyed and stormy. Oh, just when I thought my heart was finally numb, a beautiful young man appears before me, singing, "Come, oh, won't you come?" And what can I do if finally, for the first time, the one I'm burning for returns the glow? If love has come at last, it's picked the worst time. Still I know I've got to go my own way. Goodbye, my